They began queuing before dawn on Monday to view the German theologian's body, which was transferred early in the morning from the monastery in the Vatican grounds, where he died on Saturday, aged 95. Members of the public are allowed to view the body during daytime, passing first through the metal detectors used routinely to screen visitors to the Basilica. For me, the Pope is a figure who sacrificed so much for the Church, not only for the Church, but also to unite humanity. This, to me, is a great thing, which I like. In part, he was a good Pope. Perhaps it was little understood because he was a theologian Pope. To understand theology, you need to be prepared. Otherwise, you can't understand certain things. Benedict led the Catholic Church for 8 years to 2013 before becoming the first pope in 6 centuries to step down, citing declining health. His successor, Pope Francis, will lead the funeral on Thursday in St. Peter's Square before Benedict's remains are placed in the tombs beneath the Basilica. He will be buried in the tomb which held Pope John Paul II's remains until 2011, Vatican spokesman Matteo Bruni said Monday. Benedict's body, dressed in red-purple mourning robes and a gold-edged mitre, was laid out on a catafalque draped in gold fabric in front of the altar of St. Peter's, flanked by 2 Swiss guards. Many of those filing past took pictures on their smartphones, while some prayed or made the sign of the cross. I came with the sense and the desire to contemplate the very fact of seeing the body of Benedict XVI, and so I welcomed him, and it was quite quick to pass by and see, and then we stayed in the Eucharist to finish contemplating the mystery that was there in this body, which is dead, but I think it means a lot.
It's
amazing. You feel the universal church in a very different way, and just, you know, in St. Peter's it feels like heaven is opening up. So it was very quiet and respectful and beautiful. It was impressive. Yeah.
I am glad I came here this morning. When I woke up, I had no intention of coming here. When I opened the door to my room, my tag from World Youth Day, which took place in Germany, fell off. That tag is a reminder of my World Youth Day with Pope Benedict XVI. It was said an infinite joy. I said, God, here I am. My feet don't work so well this morning, but I am coming to you anyway. Over 70,000 people have paid their respects since Monday, according to the Vatican. Benedict died at the Mater Ecclesiae monastery, where he had lived for the past decade. His last words in the early hours of Saturday were said by the Vatican to have been, Lord, I love you. Thursday's funeral is unprecedented in modern times in that it will be presided over by a sitting pontiff. Benedict's shock resignation created the extraordinary situation of having 2 men in white, both him and Francis, at the Vatican. Papal deaths usually trigger the calling of a conclave of cardinals to elect a successor, but this time Francis remains in post and will lead proceedings. The Vatican has yet to release details of the guest list, beyond saying it will include delegations from Italy and Germany. The last papal funeral of John Paul II in 2005 drew 1 million faithfuls and heads of state from around the world. But Benedict has been an ex-pope for longer than he was pontiff, and he was a more divisive figure. A brilliant theologian, he alienated many Catholics with his staunch defense of traditional values, and as Pope, struggled to impose his authority on the Church as it battled a string of crises, including over clerical sex abuse. His successor cuts a very different figure, and Argentine Jesuit who is most at home among his flock and has sought to forge a more compassionate Church.